Hi and welcome. Once a product is developed by an organization, then it takes numbers of steps to be finally acceptable by a customer organization. And these steps involve verification, validation, certification, and accreditation. In this video, I will explain each of these terms involved in product acceptance process, including their relation to each other. Now, this is a product, and in verification, we basically carried it out at the end of product development life cycle. And we basically check that whether this product meets the technical specification and design, which was earlier formulated with the help of user's requirement. So in this process, we check that whether we have developed the product in a right manner as per the technical specification or the user requirement which we have gathered earlier. So if it is not the case, then we need to improve this product by doing another iteration. So this process of verification is carried out by the organization who has developed this product. So it is an internal process to that organization. So if the organization meets, or if the product meets this verification requirement, that it meets the technical specification, then we follow the next phase, that is the validation. Now, in validation, this is basically carried out by the customer organization, where it is checked that whether this product also meets the real world customer requirement. So in this process, we check that whether we have developed a right product or whether this product is not the right for the job which it is required to do. And it can be a case that a product can be verified to meet the technical specification or the user requirement, but it is not validated to meet the real world requirement or the operational requirement where this product is going to be deployed. And this is caused by the inconsistency in gathering the user's requirement. Now, this validation phase also involves two additional steps, that is the accreditation, certification, and accreditation. Now, these are the additional steps which are required by the military organizations for their defense contractors if they want to deploy a system in military organization. Now, certification is followed by the accreditation, that we perform certification first and then it is followed by the accreditation. So certification is basically the technical evaluation and accreditation is a management approval. So this certification is very much alike the verification, but this is more granular than the verification, because the certification criteria is scoped by the certification body or the customer. So in this case, we check that whether a product meets is suitable to be deployed in a specific environment, because same product can be deployed in different configurations in different environment. So a product may be suitable for one environment but not suitable for another environment. So this certification basically supports the decision which will be taken up in accreditation process by the management. So in accreditation, this is actually the management process where the management accepts the certification earlier done by the technical people, and it accepts this certification including any risks associated by deploying this product in an operational environment. So after carrying out accreditation, this product is approved to be deployed in an operational environment. So this was all from my side. Please stay connected to my channel for similar videos. Thank you.